This huge water bird is an awe-inspiring symbol of love, wisdom, and peace. But did you know that in the past, these birds were considered a delicacy, till like the 1700s? And what is the purpose of that strange knob on their bills? This is Cygnus olor, the mute swan. Mute swans are huge birds, with a wingspan of up to 2.5 meters. While not as large as the trumpeter swan, which has a wingspan upwards of 3 meters, these are still huge waterfowl. In fact, they're the second largest extant species of waterfowl on Earth. Adult mute swans are completely white, except for the bill, which is orange with a black knob, and the feet, which are some shade of gray, but the feathers are all white. Young mute swans, known as cygnets, are grayish, with gray to pink bills. There also aren't many birds you confuse with mute swans. There's the other three species of white swans, the trumpeter, tundra, and whooping, but as you can see, they all lack the bill knob, so look for that and you'll have no issues. There's also the snow goose and the smaller Ross's goose, that are white waterfowl as well, but they are smaller and have very different bill shapes, again lacking the knob, as well as black wingtips, so don't get them confused. Other than that, these birds are incredibly easy to identify. Despite the name, these swans do make noise, though not as often as a flock of geese, nor as often as a louder whooping swan. Mute swans sound like this. Mute swans are native to Europe and Asia, with the complete extent of their range changing over the past 1,000 years, due to localized extinctions and reintroductions. They have also been introduced to North America, Japan, New Zealand, as well as Australia, as seen on this map. I recorded all the mute swan footage shown in this video within the mute swan population introduced to the Great Lakes region of Ontario. You've heard of the deadly cobra chickens, also known as Canada geese, that for some reason so many people are afraid to get attacked by. When you really shouldn't be, as Canada geese can't actually hurt you. I'll be doing a video on them soon, so make sure to subscribe if you don't want to miss that. But swans are much larger, and will also hiss at you if you encroach on their territory. And like geese, swans have small serrations on the inside of their bills, called lamellae. These comb-like structures, along with serrated tongues, assist in gripping food. I mean, look at this dinosaur! How can people see this and still try to deny that birds are descendants of the non-avian dinosaurs? Which they totally are. In fact, since organisms can't evolve out of a clade, all birds are dinosaurs. And swans, along with the other fowl, are some of the most primitive extant birds. Modern birds of the clade Aves are split into two clades, the Paleognathae, containing the ratites, which contain birds such as the emu, kiwi, and the tinamous, and the Neognathae, which contains all the other extant birds. The Neognathae is then split into the Galloanserae, which contains the waterfowl, such as swans, and the landfowl, such as chickens, which are then sister to the Neowaves, containing the rest of the birds. Within Galloanserae, the swans obviously belong to the waterfowl, known as the Ansery forms, within which they belong to the family Anatidae, along with the other ducks, geese, and swans. Within Anatidae, the mute swan falls into the subfamily Anserinae, the geese and swans. Intergenera relationships within the Ansery forms are a highly debated topic, but it appears the genus Cygnus, the swans, is either sister to a pairing of Corse caraba and Cereopsis, with that clade sister to the pairing of Anser and Branta, the true geese. Or placing Cygnus sister to the true geese, with that clade sister to Corse caraba and Cereopsis. Overall, more genetic testing is required to confirm these relationships. There are 6 species of swan within Cygnus, and Cygnus olor, the mute swan, was initially thought to fall in a clade with the other white swans of the Northern Hemisphere. However, mitochondrial DNA analysis instead suggests a sister relationship with the black swan, Cygnus atratus, of Australia, with that pairing probably sister to Cygnus melanocorypheus, the black-necked swan of Argentina. Mute swans are primarily herbivorous, primarily feeding on aquatic vascular plants and algae, which they gather by dabbling, similar to gadwalls and mallards, where they feed on the surface by selecting food by taste and touch, or upending when they dunk their heads and necks underwater and wraith their butts in the air to reach deeper vegetation. In addition, like most animals, if given the opportunity, swans won't hesitate to gulp down a frog or fish that wanders too close. Quite a fumble. Swans are also fed by humans in city parks throughout their range. And while bread handouts are an easy source of food for these birds, bread can actually negatively impact their health. So next time you want to feed swans or geese at a park, try bringing healthier food, such as birdseed, oats, cracked corn, or vegetables like lettuce. These are much better for the health of these birds. Mute swans are monogamous, and many of them mate for life, though they sometimes go through divorce, particularly after a failed breeding season.
I guess raising a family is tough.
Pair formation generally occurs from winter to spring, when the knobs on males become larger and brighter, possibly a signal of health and sexual maturity. During this time, the male and female press their necks up against each other, even crossing them. Then the male mounts the female, gripping her neck with his beak, and unlike most birds, which transfer sperm with a cloacal kiss due to lack of penises in males, swans and other waterfowl retain the penis and inject sperm directly into the female. The pair usually returns to the female's place of birth, and the male begins construction of multiple nests, generally close to water, on the shores of wetlands, islands, lakes, and ponds. The female chooses one of these sites that the male began construction on, then they work together to complete the construction of the large platform made from reeds and other vegetation. Pairs will fiercely defend territory from intruding swans, and possibly predators as well. The female then lays 5 to 8 large greenish-white eggs that are roughly 6 times the weight of a standard chicken egg. The female performs the majority of incubation by pressing her brood patch, a bare section of skin with lots of blood vessels, against the eggs, with the male just taking over when she goes to feed. Cygnet hatchlings are able to leave the nest and begin swimming and feeding shortly after hatching, but are assisted by and protected by both parents, and they may even spend the first winter as a family group before departing to raise their own families. Swans are big animals, and that provides protection against predators, with coyotes being the main predators of nesting adults, while foxes, hawks, snapping turtles, owls, and pike prey on cygnets. And raccoons, foxes, and otters will take eggs as well. There are even cases of large northern pike attacking and injuring adult swans. Though disease, poisoning, and death due to human structures account for the majority of mute swan deaths, ansory forms were present during the late Cretaceous and survived the KT mass extinction that wiped out the non-avian dinosaurs. While Anatidae is thought to have split sometime during the early Oligocene, while Anatinae, the pairing of swans and geese, originated in the middle Miocene. And finally, Cygnus split from them through the late Miocene, originating in Europe and spreading throughout the Northern Hemisphere through the Pliocene. When the southern swans split from the northern is uncertain, but the fossil record is quite impressive, with swans from all over the world, likely including the southern hemisphere ancestor of the mute swan. The mute swan is an incredibly interesting species. Until next time on Animal Analysis, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and comment on which animal we should analyze next. And maybe check out one of these other videos.